How's it going, fellow traders? Magic Trader here. And this is the CFTC report for the data that was recorded on October 26, 2021. So we'll start by taking a look at gold, as we always do. Happy Halloween, by the way. October 31st. It's time for Halloween. Take the kids out. Get some candies. Spook yourself out. This is a good movie, by the way. Trick or Treat. That's freaky. I watched it with my wife a couple years back, and it was freaky. Anyways, let's get down to business. We have gold here, and we take a look at the positions of the banks, the longs. Look at the longs. 299 up to 2 up to 313, sorry. And look what's been happening with short positions, declining since 125 all the way down to the 99s, all right? So what is that telling me? Well, that's telling me that they're not really focusing on short positions right now, and it makes me really wonder why they're not focusing on short positions. Is it because they're planning on taking this higher? I mean, I guess it's possible. But the thing is, when you look at the euro and you see the weakness that's coming into it, it would lead us to suspect that price is actually going to drop. But they've been increasing their longs since contracts expired, and they've been decreasing their shorts. So, you know, the data is not supporting a drop in price. So bottom line, we still have demand holding here, which we need to see removed. And if that doesn't get removed, then we'll expect more upside on the charts. All right, next we have oil. And oil over the last couple of weeks, short positions have been extremely cooled off. Look at that. Okay, we used to be at 159, now we're at 136, and now dropped one more time, 126. Very cooled off. And with good reason, because we've spotted this momentum to the upside for quite some time now, and it's rallying strong, very strong. Very good support structure here, uptrend on the weekly chart. We have targets even higher on the chart, so we are expecting oil to continue its rally. US dollar, longs are more aggressive, shorts are cooled off. That leads us to suspect that price is going to head higher. We do have targets higher. Price rallied up, came down into this area of demand that we located, and now we're seeing that push to the upside. If the momentum on the lower time frame charts continue to the upside, we expect these targets to be contacted. Next, we have the Aussie. Aussie longs are very cooled off. And so we know that this pressure to the upside has been built up by the closure of short positions. Okay, they closed a bunch of short positions, which fueled a move to the upside. So be very careful with this one, because this could turn and head south anytime soon. US CAD. Our target was hit. We got out of the trade. Now we have longs being reduced and shorts becoming aggressive. They went from very cooled off short positions to now aggressive. So what is coming? Well, we do see the dollar building momentum to the upside, so we could see more momentum to the upside on this one. Okay, it is possible. Overall, longer term, we do suspect that we're going to see price drop. All right, so we'll be keeping an eye on that. US Swiss franc, look at that. Shorts are so cooled off. They're so small compared to the long positions. Look at long positions compared to its average. Look at short positions compared to its average. I mean, there's nothing indicating that there's going to be a push lower in price. It's all uphill from here. And once this area of supply gets removed, it's going to go up strong. Okay. Also notice where we hit that supply at the test of the trend line. Once this trend line gets taken out, boy, this will fly up with a lot of momentum. Euro. So we are watching for this area to get taken out. It did. It produced a supply area here by the banks. They reversed price up into that area of supply, and then just as we had suspected, massive drop from that supply. So we're seeing a lot of momentum to the downside now. And if it continues to build momentum on the lower time frame charts, we expect our targets to be contacted. Pound, there's not much here. It's just going in a direction with the euro, as we have been speaking about. Recently, short positions became very cooled off, while long positions increase. Okay, that's all I can tell you. U.S. dollar, Japanese yen, very strong momentum to the upside. They just removed the major obstacle. We have supply pushing down on price. But look at long positions. Look how aggressive. Look how cooled off short positions are. This is all indicating that this is going to continue up the charts. We have no reason to suspect that it won't. So we're expecting more upside. Last but not least, we have the Kiwi building up strength on longs. Also on shorts, not much going on here, stuck in a range, so there's not much to tell you. So there you go, there's your weekly Forex forecast with the data from the CFTC report for October 26, 2021. Have a nice, fun, and safe time with your families out there collecting candies, and I hope you enjoy yourself. All right, take care and have a good one.